It's an ability that is inherent in a lot of animals, most notably dogs, cats, mice, horses, cattle, and pigs. And they do it to help them concentrate on where sound might be coming from. It's also a useful thing to keep away pesky insects, such as flies. Yes, we're talking about the ability to wiggle the ears. Humans, of course, don't need to move their ears to focus on the source of sound or keep insects away. We have gone a lot further in the evolutionary path and lost that ability. So it thus becomes a surprise to see some person who is able to wiggle an ear, or, more amazingly, both ears. If you can move one ear, then you belong to a very small group of people who can do so. Research shows that only about 22% of the entire population of the planet can wiggle one of their ears. But if you can move both ears, then you enter an even more elite territory, as only 18% has that skill. It might be just a trick that you can do to amuse friends, but it also makes you a more unique individual. So why do some people have that ability? The answer in a short while. We'd like to ask you first to like this video. If you are new to this channel, please click on subscribe. It will inspire us to do more fun and interesting videos just for you. Now, on to our topic for today. The reason why some people can wiggle their ears is because they have an inherent ability to control their auricular muscles. Our ears, the ones that stick out of the sides of our head, are technically just shells called auricles or pinnas. Each one is connected to muscles that have supposedly lost their functions in the course of human evolution. These auricular muscles are in turn controlled by a vestigial nervous system, which means it too is not working anymore. Past research has discovered that the vestigial nervous system and auricular muscles in humans may really have been designed for the ears to respond to sounds. This means somewhere in the very distant past, people's ears really moved when triggered by a particular sound. The appendix, for its part, is an example of a vestigial organ in the body. In a 2015 study, it was shown that a very weak electrical activity in the ear muscles was produced when human participants were told to move their eyes from side to side. The outer edge of the ear also curled. It was just too subtle to be noticeable in a regular setting. Heredity may also play a role in a person's ability to wiggle their ears. A study published in the journal Hereditas in 1949 revealed that 79% of participants who were able to wiggle their ears had at least one parent who had the same ability. Additionally, 47% of the wigglers had a sibling who could do the same. So that's why some people can wiggle their ears. Some claim that they have even improved their ability through practice and concentration. But they did have the skill to begin with. Until now, there has been no proof that you can actually develop the ability if you don't have it in the first place. Aside from ear wiggling, other abilities that only a handful of people on Earth can do are tongue folding, wiggling individual toes, touching the elbow with the tongue, and bending the thumb 90 degrees in the opposite direction of the palm. We hope you have enjoyed this latest episode of Aha, So That's Why. If you did, please like it. And do subscribe to our channel to get your daily dose of fun and interesting videos. Thanks for watching.